Bloodless day. Black and white and bristling with fear, the spider hunches in plain sight on a white concrete wall, nowhere to hide. Perhaps I should kill it. Is that truly a thing people think? Perhaps it is poisonous, but yesterday, as I waited wide-eyed and goose-flushed for the first flush of dawn over the city, my anticipation ran hard into the death throes of a pig, foretelling its slaughter in a squat yard beside a wretched cabal of crowded huts. I listened, rapt, when I had meant to attend to the greeting of the sun, to the farewell of a creature I could not see, but whose mind I could clearly discern, and its squeals and screams that subsided at last to howls and moans, and then nothing at all. And today, oh, today. Today I stood under a fierce blue sky and clutched my chiffon skirts against the gazes of strange men, as if the worst thing that might happen in the day could be the gusting of the wind. I was curious, I was casual, somehow I was callous when I snapped his photo as he walked by. A lanky man in cream-colored flip-flops with a massive burden of greens and a sack on his shoulder. Green plants, white bag, brown skin, blue sky, such a tableau. 10 minutes later, or perhaps only five, I watched him tumbling in the street, tossed like greens, tossed like rags, tossed like a man hit by a car. At once a crowd surrounded him, and what aid there is here they offered, but all I could see was the tumbling, tumbling, tumbling on the hard, hot street. Later, I walked by and saw the burst bag, the squashed greens, the one cream-colored flip-flop. I did not take a photo then, so I do not kill the spider. Maybe it is poisonous, maybe it is not. But me, I know. I am round and rotten and sure with death, and still, I will let this spider live. There are no dawns without blood, though, are there?